tea. The milkman, the paper boy, evening TV. Did I get delivered here? Somebody tell me, please. This old world confuses me. Clouds as mean as you've ever seen. And a bird who knows your tune. Then a little voice inside you whispers.
Good morning, Seneca Valley. I'm Ella Reynolds.
And I'm Nicholas Schuster.
And these are your morning announcements. So today is Tuesday, and we're getting very close to Easter break. And I know for sure that I am certainly excited.
Same here.
So today we are going to be cracking eggs.
What does that have to do with Easter?
I got no clue.
Is this because we don't have the budget to actually dye eggs?
Maybe. So we are going to be cracking plastic ones with one hand and then real ones with the same hand, obviously. So Nick will go ahead and go first, and I will go at the end.
All right, let's rock and roll. Oh yeah, check this out. Oh, look, and I even got a Reese's Pieces out of this. This is really cool. Sweet. All right, your turn, Ella.
No, crack the second one.
Oh, I gotta crack the second one? Oh no. All right, this is gonna be very dangerous, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, wait, all right, wait. I gotta hold this. All right, wait, I think I got it. Nope. I know, I'm cheating. Okay, there we go. All right.
All right, so I will just wait till the end to do mine. So let's just get right into these announcements. So the next GSA meeting is today after school in room 203 of the IHS. Anyone wishing to be an officer next year should plan to attend. Attention Spark Club members, the next Spark Club meeting will be held on Tuesday, April 23rd, after school in room 2C next to the library in the senior high school. Please see Ms. Thomas if you have any questions.
Any current sophomore who is interested in applying to be on the senior high student council for 2019 to 2020 should access the online application at www.svsd.domain944. Applications are due by 2:55 p.m. on Wednesday, April 17th via email. Please contact Ms. Kerr at kerrj@svsd.net. Now let's see what's for lunch. I had no idea that pulled pork tacos were an actual thing.
I guess so, but apparently they're new here at Seneca. All right, anyone interested in running for class office next year for the junior class, please see Mrs. McLaughlin in room 56 for an application. Applications are due Wednesday, April 24th, with the election to be held on Wednesday, May 1st.
Anyone interested in running for a class officer position in next year's sophomore class, please see Mrs. McLaughlin in room 56 for an application. Applications are due Friday, April 26th, with the election to be held online on Friday, May 5th. And now we have a very interesting video about a student who's actually starting a Teens Against Cancer Club. Let's see what that's all about.
What my vision is for the impact of this club in terms of the school would be probably mostly to just bring awareness. The more that we can bring awareness, the more empathy, the more support that we can give to those who need it.
What are your thoughts on how destructive cancer has become?
It's very upsetting how destructive it's become. My grandma died from it.
How would you feel if here at Seneca Valley we started a club called Teens Against Cancer to help fund money for cancer research to give to foundations such as Make-A-Wish and Alex's Lemonade Stand?
My grandmother actually passed away 2 years ago from lung cancer, so you know I would be fully in favor of that, of spreading awareness and having a group such as that that would do that.
I also have had my life touched by cancer, so I'm invested in having the club succeed. I think that we can, you know, hopefully get our membership to grow, and once that happens, then I think as a group, you start to figure out ways to make money to support the people who need the support. Be able to raise, you know, raise enough money to give somebody a big gift or send somebody on a Make-A-Wish trip or, I think that'll all depend on what goals we set as a club.
Did you know there are over 100 types of cancers?
No, that's pretty cool. I actually didn't know that. I think it shows how like adaptive and dangerous of a disease it is that it can manifest itself in that many different forms.
Did you know in 2016, 8.9 million people were estimated to die from cancer?
No, I did not know that, but that figure doesn't simply surprise me at all because, you know, we know that cancer is one of the key health crises of our time and, you know, something that we really need to tackle as a society.
I think word of mouth is going to be the best way to get people involved. And once we get a couple, usually that grows and multiplies fairly quickly, but we'll be able to have a place for people to go here.
It's a very honorable cause, and I urge everyone to sign up because, you know, how could you not support something like, you know, going against cancer and helping people?
Very true. Attention Homework Hub participants. Grade 7 through 12. Due to PSSA testing and spring break, Homework Hub is canceled for Tuesday, April 16th and Tuesday, April 23rd. Go home on your regular bus, and we will be back in session on Thursday, April 25th. Good luck with testing and enjoy your break. And speaking of break, I now am going to crack both eggs. So first is the practice one.
Regardless what Ella does, she's still going to beat me because I technically cheated.
Yeah, because you did it with both hands.
Yeah, I know. I'm a coward, guys. I'm sorry.
All right, so now I'm going to crack the actual egg.
Oh, all right. Yep. Wow. That was good. I couldn't do that because I don't bake. But I grill, though.
One hand. All right, Seneca Valley, these are your morning announcements. Please stay tuned for tomorrow's announcements, and we will be doing an egg hunt with the preschoolers.
See you all tomorrow, Seneca Valley.